What I'm looking at today is a different way of living. The different way of living says, I am in charge of me and you are not. A different way of living says, I regard American laws and you may not. The difference is, I am a patriot and you may not be. A patriot knows what is classy. You may not. My mother and father raised me with their turn-of-the-century mentalities. They expected every child to know how to do everything, regardless of whether they were a boy or a girl. We were expected to know how to play the piano. We were expected to play a stringed instrument or a reasonable brass accompaniment. And openly, my siblings, who were much bigger and a little bit more stamina than me, played in marching bands and sang around the world and sung Sounds of Hope type of things. But the reality is that we all got evangelized. We were evangelized to know how to cook, how to clean, how to sew, how to do things with wood, and mainly with plumbing. I wish that Dad had taught us more about electricity, but that was his thing, and that's why he got the money. In America, we have rights, and when I'm looking for a wife, I'm looking for simple things. But you have to be as smart as an accountant with math. You have to be as wise as a musician with sound. You have to be as sensitive as an educator with science, technology, and nutrition. And that's sort of my volition. If you're not any of those things, by all means, don't bother. I have no interest in a dumb woman. I have no interest in a woman that plays low. And I have no interest in a gal that can't play right at the show. You see, the show is what we put forward in public. The private time is something else entirely. And openly, occasionally, those lines might cross, but we'll be in the right space at the right time to do those things. American women today are getting loose as a goose, is what my mother used to say to us, that women in the family were not allowed to play loosey-goosey, and I know what that meant back then. Today, it's hard to say what that means today. Because so many men today are so being put down for being male and being somewhat, well, prima donnas in a way, that you can't tell who is what in any way. I don't care is my attitude. God makes everyone everywhere, and that has been proven to me now over the course of almost 10 years. But my life changed completely at the heart of three women around me. My late spouse has totally changed my life. She was everything I needed as a wife. And openly, when it came time for her to move on for her situation and her needs, it was hard for me. Finding a replacement of somebody like that who was expected to be a life partner, someone who's expected to live together, someone who would finish sentences and do things like an old couple, is hard to find. But when I chose the next woman, I chose the one who was the most kind, most funny, most witty, most wise, the most that I could learn from, and the most that I could take it from. You know, because if you're going to get your ass ripped, you want it to be ripped appropriately, intelligently, and emotionally. The reality is that there was something about the fire in that girl that really allowed me to be me. On top of that, I met another woman based on prayer. And those prayers became fully realized because I put myself down on my floor with my heart, mind, and soul, and I prayed to the Lord. And into one of my classrooms on my spirituality, a class I was teaching because I met someone who was interested in me, who was an older lady, who was married, and who was kind to me, walked in the best thing that I had. And openly, it lasted a short time. But other people infiltrated it, other people destroyed it, other people didn't understand that God makes friends, and those friends are our soulmates. And those friends might be in the wrong space, the wrong time, the wrong relationship. But that's okay. That story is mine. Anyone who tries to play that shit at you is full of shit. You see, a liar in America wants to pretend he's somebody he's not. A liar in America is someone who wants to take your job and throw you some snot. American people are at risk to foreigners every year. Because a foreigner that wants to come here, play here, stay here, and be here without legitimate rights to do so is a liar in America. We don't need foreign students anymore, I feel is true. We have to focus on educating our own people, and that may be your child or you. In America, we have rights, and we have to start to work towards America Inc. as a community, as a family of American citizens of diversity. Diversity is being now and becoming perversity. I am so offended by the scenes I see of young black people, it makes me ill. I cannot fucking believe that we've lost people like Maya Angelou and others after what I see. Because what I see is an entitlement thinking that I'm going to produce a scene in front of a 10-year-old boy or a 10-year-old girl of profanity, of cursing, basically, of shouting, of doing all this stuff as if it's okay. It's not okay, motherfucker. You want to fuck up your own child, take him home and fuck him up like you always do. But if you want to be someone in America, you teach children what is true. If you have a problem with your boyfriend, then maybe she's not good enough for you. If he's an alcoholic or a drug addicted man, I think you chose wrong. There's no amount of play that's worth that shit. I experienced that throughout my family, and I didn't like it one bit. In America, we have rights to decide who is perfect for us, who is right for us, not only in our family, in terms of a significant other or lover, but in terms of our friends, people who can like us, support us, and talk to us about the subjects that are important to us. I am a family-oriented man. I have suffered through tons of books on rearing wayward children because I had one. And openly, I know what to do with kids as an educator. But I'm not dumb about American citizenry, that people don't take the time to be a good parent. They don't take the time to read a book. They don't take the time to do anything but shout, scream, and look as if we have to watch them like TV. What a bunch of shit you're putting out in the community. In life, I'm not only talking about one color of citizen. I've seen wayward Indians, I've seen immature whites, but most of the time, when you see a Mexican child, they're pretty well behaved. But that doesn't mean they're not stealing you blind. In America, we have rights. And I'm not being perverse, I'm not being ethnocentric, I'm not being racist, I'm talking about observations. General observations that create a consistent pattern. When I observe patterns of people, I start to go, okay, I guess that's them. When I see patterns of generosity, then I say, okay, that's them. But stupid people like to lie, steal, and cheat because they got off track with love, not at all, but with drugs, alcohol, and stupid aspects and ideas about sex. They also come from impoverished mind thinking, and they never and are unwilling to get out of that. I can't change my life today is what they think. Bullshit. Pick your ass up, go to a library, spend your days there, spend your hours there, and read until you find a way to get a new job that's fly. American companies need people who are honest and true. America is about the red, white, and blue. The red is for the blood that has been shed across all ethnic races, all people, and every places to protect American soil from within and without. The blue is for the tears that many people, many families have shed for people like you in empathy, which is the most important property you can teach a child, is to be empathetic to other people's cares, other people's woes, and other people's even prosperity. The white is for the purity of the American patriot, who recognized that the White House was labeled that for that reason, and the White House is simply a building. And in that building is represented every American citizen. The blacks who work in that building are the greatest honored citizens in America because they are entrusted with the lives of the people who live there. And those lives of people who live and work there are the ones that are guiding our nation around the world. If you fucking think you can be president today, then walk your ass across that lawn and say, hey, I'd like to work here. But most of you won't pass the screen test. So let's be clear. There's different types of quality people out there, but who you choose to be is who you choose to be. If you continue to choose to be an asshole like your father, that's on you, not on me.